there have been four recent studies that have really updated the figures on the number of people that die in the process of us trying to help them, that is, from our own mistakes. And ProPublica, this research powerhouse that does investigative journalism as a public charity funded by some of the biggest philanthropists in the world, it's the envy of where every editor and writer wants to work in New York. ProPublica did a several month-long study analyzing all the data. They interviewed many of us in the academic circles and tried to update the figure. And you know what the low end of the range is that they identified? 210,000, the number of deaths from just pure medical mistakes. Now, this is based on sound evidence, and this is the low end of the range that they identified. Now, these numbers can be numbing, and you know, I think of my own roommate in med school, and he was watching an interview with Bill Gates, and Bill Gates was asked, "How much money do you have?" And he said, "Oh, it's abstract, it has no meaning." And my roommate says, "That's how I feel about my debt." Right, these numbers can be completely numbing, especially when we're teaching our medical students about the magnitude of the problem. Well, let me put the problem in some context. If we look at the CDC most common causes of death in the United States, the number one most common cause of death in the U.S. is heart disease, about 600,000 lives a year. Number two, soon to be number one, is cancer, as environmental exposures continue to increase and heart disease therapy continues to improve. Very soon, cancer will be the number one cause of death. It's about tied. Number three right now is respiratory diseases at 138,000 deaths a year. 210,000 falls as number three. We're writing this up for the BMJ. Medical mistakes are the number three cause of death in the United States. This is not a naturally occurring disease. This is a manufactured, unintended consequence of our amazing healthcare system. Now, we'd spend a lot of time and money talking about number one, heart disease, and a lot of time and money talking about number two. But who would have ever thought that the most dangerous procedure in America's emergency rooms is a patient handoff? We focus the entire training of 4 years of med school, 5 years of residency, 2-3 years of fellowship on the technical skills and the diagnostic identification that triggers this reflex to treat, but we don't talk about appropriateness that much. We talk about in surgery when to operate, but we don't talk about when to not operate that much. And it turns out knowing when not to operate is the more difficult judgment call.